Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of Next.js, that is Next.js version 15 on the Windows operating system. And after that, I'm also going to show you how to create a simple Next.js project and how to run that on our browser. So to watch the video till the end, I can guarantee if you watch the video till the end, you'll be learning a lot of new things. And if you still face any issues in middle, you can always ask me on comment section. And I'm also on Instagram now, so you can also ask me over there as well. I'll definitely going to help you. And now to install Next.js, you'll need basically two things. One is Visual Studio Code, basically a text editor where you should be writing your code for Next.js. And another thing that you'll need is Node.js. So let's download those couple of two softwares first. Just simply go to your favorite browser and then you need to search over here Node.js download, hit enter. So they are going to show you this nodejs.org as a first result. So you need to click on this Node.js download and immediately it's going to redirect to the official site of Node.js. Here you'll see we have all these different tabs called Packet Manager, Pre-built Installer and all. You need to switch to this Pre-built Installer and here you will see all these different node versions. So when you click on that, you will get all these different versions, right? So from here, I'll always recommend you to download the LTS version. So latest version of LTS is version 22, so which is what we need to download. So just select that and click on download Node.js version and immediately we'll see that our file is rightly started downloading. So that is all about Node.js. Next thing that you will need is Visual Studio Code. So Visual Studio Code download, hit enter and you will get this code.visualstudio.com. so just go inside this link, the official site of Visual Studio Code. So again, this link and both Node.js link I'm going to provide right in our description. So once you are here, depending upon what operating system you are using, you need to proceed with that. I'll for Windows I'll click on that. So thanks for downloading VS and our Visual Studio Code is also rightly started downloading. So now let's minimize this and let's go to our download directory. So both our Node.js and Visual Studio Code is rightly downloaded over here. Let's install it one by one. Just double click on Node.js installer and there you go. Just simply click on next. So accept the license agreement. You can always read this. Click on next. So this is where our Node.js is going to be installed. Everything is fine. Click on next. And all these different packages it's going to install along with setting up on the setting up the environment variable on our environment path. So everything is fine. Click on next. And here it is asking whether you'd like to install Chocolaty. I don't want to install Chocolaty. Just skip that. Click on next and install. So it's going to ask you for administrative privileges. Click on yes. And there you go. You can see that our Node.js is rightly started installing. So let's wait for a couple of minutes. So by the time our Node.js get installed, I'll request you please do consider subscribing our Geeky Syntax channel. Here also regularly I'm posting a lot of coding related videos. So please do subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel along with Geeky Script blogging channel. Now you can see that our Node.js is rightly installed. Just simply click on finish. So now that our Node.js is installed, it's time to install our Visual Studio Code. Just simply double click on that. Accept the license agreement. You can always read this. Accept the license agreement and click on next. So this is where our Visual Studio Code is going to be installed, totally fine. Just simply click on next, and I'll recommend you to select all these different options and click on next and install. So you can see preparing to install and it's going to immediately start installing our Visual Studio Code. So you know, let's minimize our download directory and let's wait for a couple of minutes over here and there you go. So you can see that our Visual Studio Code is rightly installed. Our desktop shortcut is also created over here. So everything is fine and good. You can always click on finish. That's going to launch our Visual Studio Code. So you can see Visual Studio Code is rightly launched. So let's close this. And now that both our Visual Studio Code along with Node.js is rightly installed, now it's time to create Next.js app. So for that, let's right click and create a new folder over here. So let's create a new folder and let's name this folder as Next.js 15 and go inside that folder and then you need to just simply click on this address bar and type cmd and hit enter. So what it will do is it's going to open our command prompt right at this location, so within Next.js version 15. All right, And now to create a Next.js project, all you need to do is you need to run this command called npx space create dash next dash app, and then you need to provide name of your project. So, you know, let's give name of our project as Hello World and simply hit enter. So this is our command, npx create dash next dash app, then give a space and then you need to provide your project name. So in my case, I am giving a project name called Hello World. All right. And immediately it's going to ask you, you know, that it's going to create a project called a project version 15.0.3. That is the latest version of Next.js at the time of making of this video. So whether you'd like to proceed with this or not. So yes, I want. So just simply type Y and hit enter. And next it's going to ask whether you'd like to use TypeScript or not. So you have in the keyboard, we have this arrow key, so you can toggle between this no or yes by just, you know, pressing on that arrow key. I want TypeScript, so I'll keep on yes and hit enter. So same I'll do for ESLint, hit enter. Again, I want a Tailwind CSS class as well, so hit enter. And again, it is asking whether you'd like to create a src folder. Yes, I want, so I'll toggle it to yes and hit enter. And now it is asking whether you'd like to create an app router. You can always create, so I'll hit yes. And it is asking whether you'd like to use Turbo Pack for your next dev. I don't want it. It's going to be a very simple project, so I'll keep it no. And here it is asking whether you'd like to customize import alias and not. So again, I'll keep it simple, so I'll give no. And there you go. So using npm, it's rightly started initializing our project, and it is rightly started creating. So you need to have active internet connection for this, and it's going to take some time, couple of minutes maybe. So now after that, I'm going to come back to this video. So we'll come back, and now you can clearly see that our Next.js app is actually created. So success. So created Hello World at this location. So here also you can see that our Hello World project is rightly created over here. So everything is good. If you just simply go inside this folder, you'll see all these different files and folders over here, including src folder and everything. So let's minimize this, and here just simply go inside that folder on our command prompt. So just simply type cd, then give name of your project, which is Hello World, and hit enter. So currently we are inside our project called Hello World. And now to open this same project within Visual Studio Code, we have a shortcut called code dot. So just simply type code dot and hit enter. Immediately what it's going to do is it's going to, you know, launch our project within Visual Studio Code. So you can always click this I trust the authors and all, and here if you see that our Hello World project is rightly open within Visual Studio Code. So that's a, you know, trick I just wanted to show you. All right, so now that it is open, you can always expand your src folder. You will see a font folder, favicon and all that. If you go to this page.tsx, you will see, you know, everything is written over here. Right, so let's say you want to run this project. So how to run that? First thing that you need to do is you need to go to this explorer. You will see a triple dot over here. You need to click on that, and then you need to enable this npm script. See, you need to just click on that. So immediately you will get npm scripts, you know, rightly over here. So you need to go to this triple dot and you need to enable this npm scripts. Once you do that, you will get npm scripts over here. You need to expand this and you will get all these different shortcuts, right? So next dev is what we're going to execute. So just click on this run button for next dev, and immediately on our terminal, you'll see that this command called npm run dev rightly started executing. So it's going to build our project and it's going to launch it by providing one URL. And immediately we'll see it's going to show you this result called Hello World at the rate 0.1.0, that is the version of our project is rightly created. And here is our URL that I was talking about. So our latest version of Next.js version 15.0.3 project is up and running at this URL. So just, you know, simply press Ctrl on your keyboard and click on this link. So follow link, and immediately on our default browser, it's going to start launching our project. And there you go. So you can see that our Next.js is up and running, right? So everything that you are seeing over here is actually coming from this page.tsx. So let's say you'd like to remove everything that is within this return, you know, that we are passing over return. So let's, you know, you can always use these features in the Visual Studio Code. So just collapse this entire div and then just select this and remove. All right, in this way you can remove entire stuff. And let's say let's create one tab, one h1 tag, and let's, you know, print something called hello world. All right, so just write this much, go to file and save this file, and immediately it's going to refresh on our browser. So if you go to browser, you can see that it is refreshed and it is only showing hello world on our browser, right? So yeah, so that's how you create your Next.js app, that is latest version of 15, and how to run a project. So please do consider subscribing our Geeky Syntax channel. Here also regularly I'm posting a lot of videos. So if you subscribe this channel and also watch our videos, that going to really motivate me to make more and more this kind of videos. And also if you're interested, you can also subscribe our Geeky Script blogging channel. So that is basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.